Greetings, family and friends, and welcome to Family Encounter Night here at Tuscola United Methodist Church. We pray that your family is having a fantastic week. Please take a look at our Tuscola United Methodist Facebook to keep updated on all our information on our service time, information about our pumpkin patch, and any more activities to come. We pray that you enjoy our service tonight as we bind our hearts together in worship. Now join us tonight in a time of worship.
Into marvelous light I'm running, out of darkness, out of shame. Through the cross you are the truth, you are the life.
Thank you because I am relevant in your kingdom. You, God, made us all unique. Lord, let me be the change that this world needs. Use me for this world. Let me be the salt that will sweeten this world. And let me be the light that will shine in this world.
Today's scripture comes from Genesis chapter 25, verses 19 to 28. Jacob and Esau. This is the account of the family line of Abraham's son Isaac. Abraham became the father of Isaac, and Isaac was 40 years old when he married Rebekah, daughter of Bethuel the Aramean from Paddan Aram, and sister of Laban the Aramean. Isaac prayed to the Lord on behalf of his wife because she was childless. The Lord answered his prayer, and his wife Rebekah became pregnant. The babies jostled each other within her, and she said, "Why is this happening to me?" So she went to inquire of the Lord. The Lord said to her, "Two nations are in your womb, and two peoples from within you will be separated. One people will be stronger than the other, and the older will serve the younger." When the time came for her to give birth, there were twin boys in her womb. The first to come out was red, and his whole body was like a hairy garment, so they named him Esau. After this, his brother came out, with his hand grasping Esau's heel, so his name was Jacob. Isaac was 60 years old when Rebekah gave birth to them. The boys grew up, and Esau became a skillful hunter, a man of the open country, while Jacob was content to stay home among the tents. Isaac, who had a taste for wild game, loved Esau, but Rebekah loved Jacob.
Greetings, all. On our Wednesday nights here at Family Encounter Night, we have been looking into the book of Genesis, all the way from the beginning of Genesis. We talked about the creation story and God's wonderful creation, and then we went into God's promise to Abram, and then from Abram we went to Isaac, and then tonight we're looking at the story of Isaac and Rebekah. And they had the two twin sons of Jacob and Esau. And I love this story particularly because I am a twin, and but I have a female, so, and we do not look alike. I get that all the time. Are you identical or are you fraternal? A boy and a girl twin is not identical. Fraternal means we look apart. We look different. We don't look the same, you know. I don't have long hair or anything, so no, we're not identical. But 2 points I want to make up in our scripture reading tonight from Genesis. The first point is, what are you doing in the gap? What are you doing in the gap of time? And then the second point is that there's a place for your uniqueness in his kingdom. And the first point, what are you doing in the gap? See, Isaac and Rebekah came married and got married at the age of 40. But the word tells us that they did not have their twins until 60. So if you look at that, that is a 20-year gap. I wonder, in that time of waiting, all the different emotions they must have felt. I'm sure there was anger, there was frustration, there was shock, there was disbelief. But the Bible tells us in that gap, that they prayed, and they prayed, and they went to God. And so I want to encourage us tonight that sometimes we have things that we go to God to in prayer, or things that we were waiting for those blessings. And instead of being negative in that gap or being frustrated, I mean, those are natural feelings. But we can always look to God in prayer, because God is faithful and he answers our prayers according to his perfect plan for our lives. So in that gap, we can pray, we can worship, we can thank God, we can, you know, just really look at that time in that gap to be positive, because God's going to see us through. The second point tonight that I want us to leave with is, your uniqueness is important to his kingdom, that he has a place for each and every one of us in his family. And that's what makes us a part of his family, is our uniqueness. And so in Isaac and Rebekah, when they had Jacob and Esau, you know, the Bible tells us that they were different.
It tells us that one of the sons came out with red hair, you know, and, you know, probably looked quite different. And then it really doesn't give us a description of the son. And it says not only they were different in appearance, they were unique in the way that they did things. And we see this all the time there. You know, if you look across your office or you look across your classroom or, you know, looking across the sports field, you see people that are different, you know, shades of colors, different sizes, different ages. And God loves us in our uniqueness. And that's what makes us a part of his family and sets us apart, that we are unique by the way that God has physically made us. But not only that, we're unique in the way that we do things. I want you to think of some of those weird things you do. One of the things I love to do is take ketchup and mayo and put them together, and I mix them together and I dip fries in it. And I love that. That's one of my favorite combinations. But some people can look at that and go, oh, you're so weird, and that is just gross, right? And but that's something that is unique to me, something that I love to do. And so think about tonight, what are some of the unique things that you do that might, when others look at that, go, whoa, that's just weird, you know? But God accepts our uniqueness, and that's what set us apart as he continues to work in our lives. So this week, I want you guys to continue to be who God has created you to be. Be unique in your jobs, be unique in your school, be unique in your home, because God has created us in his image, in his likeness, and so he accepts us in our uniqueness. And so your spiritual practice today or this week as a family is, I want you to think of ways that your family share similar qualities. Maybe what are some things that you do or some ways that you look? Maybe you guys all have the same eye color. Maybe you guys all have the same hairstyle. Maybe you guys like to read the same books. And go ahead and just jot those down or talk about them at the dinner table. And then also, I want you guys to think of things that are unique to you. Although you're a family, although we're a family of God, we are still unique to him. And so I want you guys to be encouraged this week that you're unique. He made each and every one of you guys in his image, and there's room for you in his family and his kingdom. I hope you have a blessed week and use your uniqueness to glorify him in all that you do. May you continue to worship God tonight with us.
When everything's breaking, you are left unshaken. When everything's tumbling down, you're the solid ground. Nations could be quaking, economies failing. When fear is found all around, you're the solid ground. Our God, you are all that you say. Be shaken. We shall not be shaken. When everything's breaking, you are left unshaken. When everything's tumbling down, you're the solid ground. Nations could be quaking. Economies failing. When fear is found all around, you're the solid ground. Our God, you are all that you say you are. You never change, you never fail, you never fade. Our God, you are faithful in all you. Forever you stand, forever you reign, forever remain. We shall not be shaken. We shall not be shaken when all around is sinking sand. For you are never changing. You are never changing. Be shaken, we shall not be shaken when all around is sinking sand. You are never changing, you are never changing, you stand. The great I am, the great I am, our God, you are.
Keep you.
May the Lord make his face shine upon you
and be gracious unto you.
May the Lord lift up his countenance upon you
and give you peace.
Amen.